was a little bit taller. I wish I was a baller. I wish I had a girl with a good, I would call her. Wish I had a rabbit and a hat with a bat and a 6-4 baller.
Where's Henry?
Where's Henry?
Hey SL, I'm Ian.
And I'm Sam, and we're your first anchors of the new year.
We understand the pain of the first day back from Christmas break, and just being awake is most likely an unworldly struggle. So on a more positive note, did you have a nice break, Sam?
Yes, I did. I went bowling a lot, and it was a good time. And
so anyways, seniors, okay. The mock elections are due by Wednesday the 9th, so be sure to get those in. And make sure to vote for me and Sam for everything.
Yes, literally every single category. Also, if you're dual enrolling in community college, you gotta get those grades in as soon as they are final.
You know what, Sam? I think we should kind of change it up a little bit and just take it straight to a video.
I think so too. That sounds like a good plan. So let's take it to a video about the intricate and frankly world-shattering art of how to operate a vehicle in the wasteland known as winter.
I'm sure you guys are aware of the dangers of texting and driving and distracted driving.
But like a lot of other drivers in Michigan, you probably don't know how to drive in the winter.
So today we're going to be showing you how to drive safely in the winter.
Always make sure you keep a blanket in your car in case something happens and you get stranded and you can't use your car's heat. At least this will keep you a little bit warm until help arrives. Also, make sure to always have a scraper. Always keep a pair of mittens or gloves inside your car so you can put them on when your car is just getting started and your hands don't get frozen by touching your cold steering wheel.
I wish I had some gloves.
Always make sure to scrape the front and rear windshields of your car, and always make sure you dust off the top of your car to make sure no snow flies on top of the other cars behind you.
Always make sure that the temperature of your engine is in between hot and cold. During the winter, you don't want your engine to be too cold, or else your engine could freeze and stall.
Always make sure that your gas tank is above a quarter tank, because if not, it may freeze up.
When driving in the winter, make sure that your windshield defrost is always on, so that your windshield stays crystal clear.
So whenever you're leaving your house, whether you're going down the driveway or just a side road, always just slam on your brakes a little to test out how slick the roads actually are and what your brakes can handle. And make sure whenever you're driving over ice to always pump your brakes instead of just slamming them so your car doesn't slide.
Always make sure that you make slow turns during the winter time. Otherwise, your car may slip and slide and go straight instead of turning when you want it to.
It's really icy outside. That means I probably shouldn't drive fast because I will lose control of my car.
Remember, black ice exists, so sometimes the roads will be very icy and slippery when you don't expect them to. Always drive with caution.
Because of the snowy roads, I hit basketball hoop and a fence. What I could have done better is press my brakes earlier and don't drive so close to the side of the road that has a fence on it.
I was turning a corner and almost hit a tree because I was going too fast, and something I could have done to prevent that is turn slower.
Okay, so my car was stationary trying to turn left on a road, and a truck was coming down and trying to turn on the road I was on, and he didn't stop fast enough. So he slid and sideswiped my car. And I mean, I couldn't have done anything, but the driver in the truck could have stopped soon.
I was driving to school and I spun out. I could have just slowed down a little bit and been more careful.
Wow, what a great high quality video from our TV2 students. What a bunch of amazing kids they are.
Especially Sam and Ian, mm-hmm. who you should vote for the mock elections.
Okay, Ian, we already said that, but yes, you should definitely still vote for us.
What's the point of holding power if you can't exploit it for personal gain?
Okay.
That's the whole point.
That's fair.
Let's take it to our sports correspondent, Madison, with some news from our athletics department.
Hey guys, it's Madison with the sports. There's a bowling meet today at 4 at Pins against Wild Lake Western. Track conditioning starts today at 3 p.m. on the track, and you can meet outside the weight room. It will continue every Monday through Wednesday until March. Tomorrow, the hockey team has a game at KV Ice House at 7 against Lumen Christian High School. That's all I have for sports today. Now back to our anchors.
Thanks, Madison.
Seniors, once again, be sure to send in pictures for the senior video.
You can do this by either sending them to the senior video staff's social media or to the email listed below.
Plus, seniors, be sure to vote for Ian and Sam for the senior mock elections.
Okay, Ian, that's enough.
I'm done.
But you should listen to him and still vote for us.
Anyways, let's take it to Annabelle with the weather.
How's it going, SL? Today we have a high of 47 and a low of 32. Before we look at the 7-day forecast, I'll tell you a joke. What do you call a lost wolf? Let's take a quick look at the 7-day forecast. Okay, so what do you call a lost wolf? A werewolf. Let's take it back to Sam and Ian.
That's really fun. I really like that.
Best right. The best one ever.
Thanks, Annabelle.
Anyone looking for any scholarship opportunities out there? Well, just check the bulletin board by the student services for all your scholarship needs.
Plus, look at the link below for Toledo scholarships if you're interested.
Finally, we've got a college visit from Cleary University tomorrow during advisory hour.
By the way, this month's library contest is for authors' birthdays in January.
Come pick up a calendar from the Media Center to fill out for a chance to get a prize.
Well, that's all for the best announcements you've ever seen.
I'm Ian.
And I'm Sam. We wish you a good day.